The Magic Kingdom will not be seeing any visitors, for now, as the Disney Corporation has delayed the reopening of its amusement park in Anaheim, California, pending new guidelines from the state government. The pullback comes as sharply increased numbers of coronavirus cases were reported in Arizona, California, Texas, Florida, and more than a dozen other states. The company still plans to reopen Disney World in Florida on July 11th, but many Floridians think that's too soon. About 10,000 people have signed a petition demanding Disney delay till the coronavirus numbers come down. Disney isn't the only one now slamming on the brakes. Apple announced it would close 7 Apple stores in Houston after recently shutting 11 of its stores in Arizona. Texas Governor Greg Abbott, who had previously pushed an aggressive restart schedule for businesses in his state, hit the pause button on further reopening.
Everyone now needs to understand the spread of COVID-19 is real in the state of Texas.
Abbott says testing shows a massive outbreak and hospitals in major Texas cities like Houston are on the verge of being overwhelmed.
People started to act like it was summer. They started to act like they wanted to go back to parties and do lots of big things like that. And it's coming back and it's biting us, quite frankly.
Airline company stocks took a big hit on Wall Street Thursday after New York, New Jersey, and other northeastern states said they'd require travelers from COVID hotspots to self-quarantine on arrival.
We also have to make sure the virus doesn't come in on a plane again.
In Washington, President Donald Trump's economic advisor ignored the overwhelming evidence of a surge.
There's a lot of positive declines in cases, just as there are negative declines in cases. So, you know, you just have to walk through that. But no, we will not shut the economy down.
Meanwhile, the Centers for Disease Control said the true number of people infected with COVID-19 in the U.S. may be 10 times higher than reported. That could mean as many as 23 million people in the U.S. have been infected, many without showing symptoms. The CDC calculated the new number based on blood sample testing from around the country for the presence of antibodies to COVID-19. Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera, Los Angeles.